is the biggest threat to the new Titans Academy? Is it the betrayer in their midst, or is it the Suicide Squad at their doorstep? Well, let's hop into the pages of Teen Titans Academy issue number 3 and find out together, shall we? So then, as we join the comic, the Elder Titans are going over everything they know about the Red X situation, and that is nothing. They know absolutely nothing about this mysterious masked individual who was stealing from them in the previous issue. They figure this Red X must be a student. The only problem is that they don't know much about all these brand new kids they've taken in. Maybe they're not cut out to be teachers after all. Hey, book, don't you start lampshading all the ridiculous things going on in this book, or I'm gonna have nothing to do for the rest of the video. Now, what are Nightwing and the others actually planning to do about this very serious threat? Nothing. In fact, they're leaving to go to Markovia to try and rescue a bunch of metahuman teens who are being kept in bondage right now, meaning that the Teen Titans team are going to be running the school in their stead. So let me get this straight. There's a potentially dangerous maniac running around your school stealing important superhero information, and your idea was to let the older kids watch the younger kids. Yeah, wow, you guys are not cut out to run a school. Then again, considering all the danger your senior heroes put you guys in as sidekicks, it's just learned behavior at this point. There's also a C-plot in this issue, as if this arc needed it, about Crush being pulled in a bunch of different directions by her space bounty hunter father Lobo. More on that in a minute. But of course, the real meat and potatoes of this one still has to deal with Red X, who it stands right now is having a meeting with the members of Task Force X, because 3 issues into this new Titans Academy book and we're already doing a crossover with another series. The squad was attempting to catch Super Speedster Bolt and force her into service for Waller. They missed their chance to capture Bolt, but now Red X says that he can get them inside the Academy. Waller agrees to this because she also thinks Red X is super freaking cool and maybe would be an awesome addition to her team one day, despite the fact that he doesn't have a bomb in his neck right now and can do whatever he wants, and working with outsiders goes against everything the squad normally does, but hey, let's just go with it. Now, on the subject of Bolt, we actually get her origin story this issue. Stop me if you've heard this one before, but apparently at some point in her life, she came in contact with a Speed Force formula. One that allowed her to access superhuman speed, but only for a short amount of time. Atlanta managed to make great use of this new ability because her parents were Aussie criminals in the outback, don't you know? So, Animal Kingdom the movie instead of Animal Kingdom the TV show. This gig was pretty good until eventually her parents' debts ended up getting too high and the underworld opted to take her legs. Wow, cutting off a young girl's legs, that is fucking grisly. This is where Amanda Waller enters the picture. She gives Atlanta experimental new blade legs like the ones that para-athletes use on the condition that Atlanta would be her spy inside the Titans Academy. And why, yes, that's now 2 massive security breaches inside this brand new Titans Academy. Seriously, did Nightwing and the others do 0 background checks on anyone? Waller got impatient, though, and as such has sent Peacemaker and the others to go and collect. There is actually a pretty fun scene where Connor, who has been shanghaied into joining the squad, sees an old picture of himself with his old teammates that he doesn't look to actually understand anymore. The Suicide Squad tries to kidnap Bolt for the 2nd time, and if you've been reading the Suicide Squad book like me, you'll know the timeline as well as several of these scenes have a ton of inconsistencies between the 2 books. The alarms on the Academy end up going off, and a massive superhuman fracas begins to take place. The big twist is that despite Red X willingly leading the squad here for no reason, he now turns on them to protect the children of the school also for no reason. The Suicide Squad is quickly overwhelmed and forced to make a teleportation escape thanks to the help of another supervillain who had seemingly died in another issue but is fine now. Crush manages to grab William Cobb the Talon before he's able to escape, and it looks like she's about to kill him before Donna Troy and the other Senior Titans step on in to stop her. Crush is greatly offended at the Senior Titans not nurturing her more murderous impulses and decides to quit the team then and there to go join her father in their new shared miniseries starting soon. You know what? I never read that Adam Glass Titans run, so I have 0 connection to Crush, but in this situation, I'm actually 100% on her side. William Cobb is a Talon, which means he's a zombie, which means he's technically already dead and has been resurrected numerous times before. Feels like Donna and the Senior Titans probably should have known that, but hey, we gotta have a cheap reason to create drama to explain why Crush won't be around in this book anymore. Now, as the comic comes to a close, we hear a bunch of the students talking about how close they were to getting killed in that last fight, and that if their teachers aren't going to be investigating Red X to their liking, then they're just gonna have to go out and investigate it themselves. And so that was Teen Titans Academy issue number 3, everybody, and oh boy, this one was not great. All the cracks that have been apparent in this series since the very beginning are becoming massive fissures now. This book continues to not really be about anyone, and without a strong POV to carry it, I find myself getting lost and not really caring about the proceedings. The only thing that really seems to be moving things forward is the mystery of Red X. The only problem, though, is that it's hard to care about Red X when their only character trait is being mysterious. Bolt actually ends up coming away from this looking better than most. I do enjoy her as a character, but 3 issues in is way too early to do a crossover with another book. Then you got all the page real estate dedicated to setting up Crush in her new spin-off book. It really communicates to me that DC editorial doesn't care about Titans as much as they seem to claim, and that they're really only thinking of this book as a way to launch other titles. The whole concept of the Teen Titans setting up a school for young heroes should have been a slam dunk, but so far the application has just been so amateurish that I'm reminded that this is actually Sheridan's first ever ongoing DC comic, despite years of working with DC characters in animation, and the whole thing just really feels like a fumble from start to finish. I would give this one a 5 out of 10.
Hey there everyone, Cape Jewel again, and I want to thank you so much for watching to the end of the video. As always, if you liked what you see, be sure to like, subscribe, comment. It really helps drive engagement and helps me out too. Also, if you are a patron, which you can become for as little as $1 a month, you will get exclusive content that no one else can ever see, and you'll get to see the Comic Multiverse podcast before anyone else too. You can check out all this and more down in the description. And until next time everyone, this has been Cape Jewel, and I'll see you all next time. Cheers.